Yinka, 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 Prophetess Yinka. You must go back to the synagogue, Prophetess Yinka. Yinka, 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 Prophetess Yinka. According to the prophecy of the man of God, oh, you must go back. Yinka, oh, Yinka, 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 Prophetess Yinka. You must go back to the synagogue, Prophetess Yinka. You must go back to the synagogue, Prophetess Yinka. You must go back to the synagogue, Prophetess Yinka. Yinka, 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 Prophetess Yinka. You must go back to the synagogue, Prophetess Yinka. Hello, everybody. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. God bless you today, tomorrow, and always. There is a prophecy for prophetess. You heard me singing. I heard that prophecy and then I started singing that song. Prophetess Yinka must go back to the synagogue. Well, actually, I think the man was referring to Yinka. He said that she must go back to the synagogue. According to him, he said he gave a prophecy last week or last 2 weeks. Was it? Okay, according to the video, because I don't actually know the date of the video. So maybe he gave the previous prophecy, which I didn't bother to actually look for. He gave that maybe a week before the first okay, I guess that should be last week. So she probably, he gave the prophecy a week after the first post TV Joshua Sunday service. You know it was within that time that Yinka came out, that made everybody know that she has started her own ministry. In case you've not watched that video, it's in this channel. Yinka has started her own ministry, and she said some things, you know, about you know, herself, and then encouraged those that she needed to encourage. But this man said this was a prophecy. I actually listened to that. I don't know if that was a prophecy or he was just giving an advice. I would like you to listen to it. God bless you.
Jesus defeated the devil on the cross of Calvary. When I look at the cross of Calvary, I see victory. When I look at the cross of Calvary, I see what? New life. Hallelujah. Yes. Last week, I think last 2 weeks, I remember when I said, when I gave a prophecy concerning about Mama Evelyn Joshua, that there are two prophets. One is a prophetess and one is a prophet. But we thank God that that prophecy was fulfilled. Yes, one of them is already at the synagogue right now as I'm speaking. Prophet Rasin is already at synagogue. Yes. Now, I said that the woman that Mama Evelyn Joshua, that she needs comfort, and in that prophecy I said that the load on her, she won't be able to bear it alone. So one of the prophet, and this one now is a lady, that Mama Evelyn meet this woman. Yes. I'll call her name. Her name is Prophetess Yinka at the synagogue. Yes. Please, I don't know what I'm seeing in the realm of the spirit. Prophetess Yinka need to be at the synagogue. The synagogue is your home. If you are listening to me, the Synagogue Church of All Nations is where you belong. Prophet Rasin is already there, which by the special grace of God, God so be faithful. Hallelujah. And we are going to see. I see the hand of God upon Prophet Rasin. What I'm seeing right now is that Prophet Racine is going to operate in the level that is going to surprise many people. Hallelujah. Yes, he's going to. Yes. So, please, if you are listening to this, you better communicate this message to Prophetess Yinka. Yes, synagogue is her home. She needs to be there. I'm seeing her at.
All right. Thank you, and God bless you. Well, I think I am prophetic to you because, you know, some of you that didn't hear when I said that the work of ministry is not an easy one, that Evelyn may not be able, or that she has found out that she needed some help. You know, we speak as sometimes human, and when we don't mean, when we don't have hatred in our hearts, and some persons may look at us as if we have hatred and we're speaking out of hatred. It is actually far from that. Why should I hate someone that is not even close to me? And so she hasn't offended me. Why should I hate in the first place? Even ones that are close to me that offend me, I have not had the strength to hate them. So this becomes an opportunity for me to address some of you followers of Evelyn TB Joshua. You need to understand, sincerely speaking from my heart, there is no hatred in my spirit. And she doesn't in any way stop me. She doesn't in any way make me feel incomplete as a human. But what I'm saying is that I did mention in that video, and you know, that's one, people will miss it, that the work of ministry was not an easy one and is still not an easy one. And she cannot do it alone. All right. That, you know, that is why I said that this, then they call it prophecy, but I'm looking at it as an advice, because he hasn't said, the Lord told me. The Lord told me. Well, I like the man because he preached well. The video is longer than what you saw, but I want you to watch it. I don't want you to watch 1 minute. I want you to watch everything. So, well, you have heard the prophecy. If it was a prophecy, if it was an advice, for me, I think it was more or less as a counsel, because there was no authority in it. There was no conviction in it. It was just sounding like a friendly advice to Yinka that she must go back to the synagogue. But then I also think, except he says the Lord told him. If the Lord has said, well, who am I to say no? But, you know, sometimes I'm not saying that this man is looking for, he's trying to trend. You know, that is not what I'm implying. But sometimes people use trending topics to also sell themselves. You understand? We will see how this unfolds. We will see if Yinka goes back to the synagogue or not. But the idea of spreading the gospel actually is, go ye out into all the world and make disciples of all nations. And so it is not a must that all of them must be peopled at Scoan. You know, it's not a must that every one of them must be assembled there in order for them to fulfill whatever they call their ministries. All right, if Yinka, as he called her, which is Yinka, you know, has decided that her path is outside of the synagogue, there's no qualms about that, except she didn't hear from God, and this man now has heard for her from God. But I wonder if a prophetess will be misled, you know, because she's a prophetess, and obviously she seems to be more prophetic and more profeting or prophetessing than this young man. He's a young minister, even though that God can use anybody. But let's know what you think about the whole thing. Prophetess Yinka must go back to the synagogue. Must she go back? Must she really go back? Let's know what you think. God bless you.